السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Teacher Fayaz Din Ahmed. Today we are going to start a new lesson from chapter 8, lesson number 1, Earth and Sun. The book is Macmillan and McGraw-Hill, and page numbers are 360 and 361 that we cover today. So can you please open your book? To start with, we'll just have a brief idea about the vocabulary here. Rotation, axis, revolution, orbit. Rotation here is with relation to the earth. This is the rotation of the earth. So the meaning of the rotation, we all know that the rotation means the act of spinning. Rotation is the act of spinning. Axis, a real or imaginary line that an object spins around. Here we are talking about the earth's axis. So, the real or imaginary line that an object spins around is an axis. And revolution here, we are talking about the Earth's revolution. So, revolution here is when one object travels around another object, we call it a revolution. And here, it's the revolution of the Earth around the Sun. Orbit, we are again talking about the orbit which the Earth takes during its revolution. So here the Earth's orbit, this is the path Earth takes while revolving around the Sun. In general, the meaning of the orbit is the path a revolving object takes. Here the path taken by the Earth while revolving around the Sun. So here we start with our lesson. What causes day and night? What causes day and night? Rotation of the Earth causes day and night. Rotation of the Earth causes day and night. Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. And 1 hour is divided into 60 minutes. And 1 minute is divided into 60 seconds. This we all know that. We'll have a picture to have an idea how the Earth rotates. Here this is a central imaginary line. This is an axis. Here the Earth's axis. This is an Earth's axis. The central line. Imaginary line around which the Earth rotates. So Earth is rotating on its own axis. We do see here the equator, the central line running east-west. The central line, this is the equator. So we'll now begin with the apparent motion. What is apparent motion? It is the way something appears or seems to move. It is the way something appears or seems to move. This is apparent motion. Apparent motion is not real motion. It is just how something appears to us. Apparent motion is not real motion. And sun appears to rise in the east and set in the west. This is also an apparent motion. Actually, this is not the case. We all know the sun is fixed at one place. It's not moving. It is the earth which is moving. So this is an apparent motion. Also, stars seem to move. This is also an apparent motion. And also moon and planets, they do not always move in the same direction as they appear to move. This is also an example of apparent motion. And shadows. We all see the shadows in the day. In the morning, we see long shadows. And again, in the middle of the day, we see very short shadows. And in the end of the day, in the evening, again, we see the long shadows. How the shadows are formed? The shadows are formed when light strikes an object and it cannot pass through it. So the shadows form. So here we see the shadows formed by the sunlight. So always the shadows point away from the sun. The shadows are formed when the sunlight strikes on an object and cannot pass through it. So the shadows form. Here we see the shadows are always pointing away from the sun. So early in the morning we see long shadows and the shadow begins to shrink as the day proceeds to the midday, and again from midday towards the sunset, again the shadow grows. The shadow grows longer and longer again. So in the morning and in the evening, the shadows are long, and in the middle of the day, the shadows are short. So this is what we cover today. Inshallah, I'll get back to you with the remaining lesson as soon as possible. Thank you. Have a nice day.